In this tutorial, I will walk you through the process of reading a journal article in order to increase your comprehension and to save you some time. Reading a scholarly article is different from reading a novel. You don't have to read every word from the beginning to the end. Before searching for journal articles, be sure to have a clear research question in mind. This will help you identify the keywords to use in a search of the literature on the subject, and find the articles of relevance to your question. In this example, I wanted to explore the effect that painting lines and logos had on football fields which had natural grass turf as a playing surface. My research question was, do painted lines on sports fields affect turf grass growth? For this example, I have used ProQuest to perform my journal search. Using the keywords turf, paint, and color, and restricting my search to peer-reviewed articles, I found this paper published in 2013 in the journal Crop Science. This article went through a process of peer review, so I can be fairly confident of the findings of this study. Peer review means that the article was reviewed by other experts in this field of research. The study was original research and was assessed for its scientific merit. Through the review process, limitations with the study, and improvements to the study or its analysis were incorporated. There are two major types of peer review articles. The first is experimental. These describe the results of new experiments. The second type is a review article. These provide an overview of currently published results in a field of research. Experimental or research papers are termed primary sources. They provide the actual description of the work, results, and conclusions drawn. Review papers summarize work done by others. Although they are grouped into a category we term secondary sources, a review paper that has been peer-reviewed is as highly regarded as a primary research paper. For this tutorial, we will focus on experimental papers. Let's open up this article published in 2013. Research articles are organized into specific sections, and they include the title and list of authors, the abstract, often keywords are provided, as well as a list of defined abbreviations. Following that is a literature review, which will include the hypothesis and the objectives of the study, the experimental methods, results, discussion and conclusion, and the list of references. For this paper, the title is Athletic Field Paint Color Differentially Alters Light Spectral Quality and Bermudagrass Photosynthesis. The authors are William Casey Reynolds, Grady Miller, and Thomas Rufty of the Department of Crop Science, North Carolina State University. The order of authors is related to their relative effort or contribution to the study. The author with the most contribution, its analysis, and the writing of the article is listed first. Note the keywords that the authors have used to describe their study. Although in my keyword search I used the word turf, perhaps I should use the term athletic field in future searches. That might uncover additional articles that may be of relevance to my topic. Now let's look at this article in more detail. Don't approach the article like you would a novel or a newspaper article. Rather than reading this 9-page publication word for word, it is more efficient to hop around the various sections contained within. What we will do is read the paper in 3 passes. In the first pass, we will read the abstract, the conclusion, and then review the figures and tables and their captions. This pass should take 10 to 15 minutes. As you gain experience in the subject area, you will find you're able to do this in less time. Our first step is to read the abstract. This is a summary of the article. As you are reading, highlight any unfamiliar words or phrases to look up later. In many papers, you will also find abbreviations used in the text. This list will appear after the abstract. In this paper, PAR is short for photosynthetically active radiation, and TCP is short for total canopy photosynthesis. In the abstract, we find that they looked at specific colors of paint and their effect on photosynthetically active radiation and on canopy photosynthesis. Based on the abstract, this article would be of help in answering the research question. Since this article is relevant to our topic, we will now jump to the conclusion. This is the last part of the discussion. Remember, this is not an Agatha Christie mystery novel. Jumping to the end of the text will not spoil the story. The last paragraph of the discussion sums up the article. It provides a summary of what was concluded and often indicates what else needs to be investigated. In this example, any alteration by plant pigments to produce a color impacted turf grass growth. Darker colors had such a shading effect, it was unclear how damage could be avoided. Now we can decide if we should invest any more time in reading the article. Based on the abstract and the conclusions, we can determine if this paper is relevant to the research question. If the answer is no, we can skip this article and go on to another. If the answer is yes, then it is worth investing more of our time in reading the article. If the article is relevant, the next step is to hop back through the article and look at each of the figures and tables presented. Some may be used to explain the technique and how the study was conducted. Most will be used to present the results from the study. The quality of the figures and captions can give you some measure of the quality of the study. A good article will figures and tables that are easy to interpret. You should not have to assume anything or to wade through mountains of text to interpret what has been presented. Figure 1 shows a schematic of a painted leaf and illustrates the possible paths that light can take: reflection, transmission, and absorption. The diagram makes it easy to interpret what the authors mean when they use each of these terms. Table 1 lists the paint colors that they used in the study. There were 10 paints, ranging from black to white in color. The Pantone colors, pigment types, and classifications are also summarized. Table 2 summarizes the results of a study which measured reflection, transmission, and absorption of different wavelengths of light. There were significant differences found. White paint had the greatest reflection, 92.6%, whereas black paint had the lowest, 4.5%. In terms of absorption, it was the reverse. White paint had the lowest absorption, with none detected, and black paint had the greatest, with 95.4% of the light absorbed. Table 3 provides a variance summary of their study, in which they measured total canopy photosynthesis. Here we can see that the study involved weekly applications of the paint over a 5-week period. There were 2 experiments conducted in a controlled environment. Also, there were significant interactions of the paint treatments over the weeks and between the 2 experiments conducted. Figure 2 provides the mean total canopy photosynthesis for each of the paint colors for both experiments. The values are expressed relative to an unpainted control. Here we can see the patterns are very similar between the treatments. White paint had the highest level of photosynthesis, about 80% of the control. And the dark colors the lowest. They were about 10 to 20% of the control. In the first experiment, there was no difference detected between black and blue paint. But there were significant differences between them in the second experiment. This is likely why the F-test and the variance analysis indicated a significant treatment by experiment interaction. In the main, however, the relative comparisons between paint colors corresponded between the experiments. The darker the color of paint, the greater was the reduction in photosynthesis. At the end of the first pass, record some notes about the article. Try to summarize the paper in a sentence or two. In your summary, include what species was studied and whether it was a field, greenhouse, or computer modeling study. Indicate if it was an observational or a design experiment, and how many replications or experiments were used. The answer to these questions can help you determine the scope of inferences from the study. For example, the results of a greenhouse study of petunias typically would not have much relevance to how corn might grow in a farm field. In this case, the summary sentences could read as follows. The reflection, transmission, and absorption, a PAR, and total canopy photosynthesis were measured following weekly application of 10 paint colors to TIFF-way Bermudagrass over a 5-week period. It was a controlled environment study with 2 repetitions. Light colors of paint had higher reflection but lower absorption of PAR compared to darker paint colors. Photosynthesis rates of plants painted with white paint averaged 80% of controls, and plants painted with black paint averaged 20% of controls. In the first pass, we concentrated on the abstract, the conclusions, and the figures and tables. The second pass is where you dig into the paper. This is where you read the introduction and the results and discussion sections. This will take more time than the first pass, perhaps an hour initially. Again, less time as you gain experience in the subject matter. The introduction, or literature review, summarizes what is already known based on previous work by other researchers and how the authors arrived at their hypothesis under investigation. Take note of the references. This may point you to other papers you may want to read. In this example, they indicate another study was done with 2 paint colors, white and red, in another grass, in this case perennial ryegrass. Perennial ryegrass is a cool season species. Bermudagrass, which the author studied, is a warm season grass. The review of literature will lead to the hypothesis developed, in this case, because different colors would impact different spectral bands. It was hypothesized that the degree of effects on total canopy photosynthesis would vary. The results section is a verbose summary of the evidence generated by the experiments. Often there are a number of experiments involved, and each will be clustered under common headings. Don't get bogged down in this section. Skim the paragraphs. You may want to spend a little more time reading paragraphs under headings that relate to your research question. The discussion section is where the authors summarize their findings and determine if the results support the hypothesis under investigation. They will also compare their findings to those of other researchers. Where the results deviate from others, reasons for the deviations will be discussed. Sometimes the reasons are speculative in nature. This section is used to develop a revised hypothesis to be tested in future experiments. The third and final pass is where you train a critical eye on the paper. This is the time for reflection and analysis. Here you focus on the evidence, arguments, and conclusions. You will spend some time in reading the methods, especially the design and analysis of the experiment. As you get more comfortable with reading research studies, you should be able to look at the evidence, the information contained in the tables and figures, and draw your own conclusions, and see if your conclusions concur with those of the authors. While reading the article, ask yourself these questions. What specific topic did the authors research? What is already known about the topic? What were the limitations to the study? Do the results apply broadly, or are they limited to specific situations? Does the data support the conclusions reached? Does it conflict with the findings by others? Do you agree with what the authors are saying? And finally, how does this article contribute to answering the research question? Finding answers to these questions will improve your comprehension of the article and help you think critically about the topic. As you perform the third pass, take notes by adding sentences to your summary from the first pass. Try to write this using your own words as much as you can. Avoid quoting sections of the paper. By the time you are done this, you will have a precis of the study written in your own words. Include the reference, the author's year, title, the journal, volume, and page numbers, as part of your notes. Then when you incorporate sentences into your report based on your notes, you won't have to go hunting for the reference to your information. I hope these tips will help you in reading articles when researching a topic using primary literature.